Hello, students. Today we are going to do the revision of chapter 7, conservation of plants and animals. Already the teacher had one time done. So now I will continue the revision of this lesson. So from this, what you will understand? Conservation means preserving the plants and animals for the betterment of mankind and all over the earth. So in last year, standard 7, you had studied some part of this lesson, conservation of environment, how to protect the environment, etc. So there last year lesson, two children, Paheli and Bhuju, had visited the forest along with Professor Ahmed and Sibu. So they want to talk about their experiences, which type of animals they had seen, what type of plants they had seen in that wildlife sanctuaries during the vacation. So they want to share with that. Other children in the class were also eager to share their experience, as some of them had visited Bharatpur Sanctuary, some others had heard about Kasiranga National Park, then Lochao Wildlife Sanctuary, Great Nicobar Biosphere Reserve and Tiger Reserve, etc. So here the children are very eager to share their experience with the other children, what they had seen in during their vacation. So here, first part of the chapter, this chapter consists of the main points like deforestation and its causes, consequences of deforestation, conservation of forest and wildlife, biosphere reserve, flora and fauna, endemic species, wildlife sanctuary, national park, red data book, migration, recycling of paper, and reforestation. So these are the main categories or the headlines of this lesson. So first we will study about deforestation and its causes. So one way we can say what is mean by deforestation. Deforestation is a major threat to the survival of wildlife. Plants utilize atmospheric carbon dioxide for photosynthesis. Deforestation increases the temperature and pollution level on the earth. So deforestation meaning a simple way we can say the destruction or clearing of forest and using the land for other purposes. Trees in the forest are cut for some purposes mentioned below. Mainly for three purposes. First is procuring land for cultivation. Due to the population, overpopulation of the world, people mainly cutting the trees and using that land for more and more cultivation purposes. Second thing, building houses and factories. As the population increases, more and more factories are coming out, and moreover, more and more residential areas, other buildings, etc. also wanted to construct it. For that purpose also, they are cutting the trees and the land using for these purposes. Third thing, making furniture or using wood as fuel. So, for cooking purposes, for burning purposes, and also for making furniture, people are cutting the trees. These are the three causes of deforestation. Now, what are the consequences or the results of this deforestation? When the deforestation takes place, what will happen? So, consequences of deforestation. First thing, it increases the level of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, and deforestation increases the temperature and pollution level on the earth. Then, groundwater level also gets lowered. Another thing, deforestation disturbs the balance in nature. So, if all the trees in the world is cutting or continuously cutting off, rainfall and fertility of the soil will decrease. So, these are all the results or consequences of deforestation. Moreover, there will be increased chances of natural calamities such as floods and droughts. So, we can say in general, deforestation increases the temperature in this world and the pollution level of the earth also increases. It increases the level of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere and groundwater level gets lowered. The deforestation disturbs the balance in nature, and due to the deforestation, rainfall decreases and the fertility of the soil also will decrease. Moreover, there will be increased chances of natural calamities such as floods and droughts. So, these are the consequences. So, you had studied now deforestation, why deforestation, or what are the causes of deforestation, what are the consequences of deforestation. The plants need carbon dioxide for photosynthesis. Fewer trees would mean the less carbon dioxide will be used as a used up, resulting in its increased amount of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. So, due to the less forest or less trees, less carbon dioxide is utilized during the photosynthesis and the level of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere is increasing. This will lead to the global warming as carbon dioxide traps the heat waves reflected by the earth. So, if less trees are there, less carbon dioxide will be utilized by the plants or the trees, and this leads to the global warming as the carbon dioxide traps the heat waves reflected by the earth. The increase in temperature on the earth disturbs the water cycle and may reduce rainfall. This could cause droughts. So, all these difficulties are interrelated. If no trees are there, more and more carbon dioxide is accumulating in the atmosphere, which leads to the trapping of heat waves reflected by the earth, and it increases in temperature on the earth, which disturbs the water level and may reduce the rainfall and causes droughts. Deforestation is a major cause which leads to the change in the soil properties. Physical properties of the soil gets affected by plantation and vegetation. So, these are also some of the results of deforestation. Deforestation is a major cause which leads to the change in the soil properties. Physical properties of the soil gets affected by plantation and vegetation. Now, if deforestation occurs, soil erosion takes place, fewer trees results in more soil erosion will be there. Removal of top layer of the soil exposes the lower, hard and rocky layers. This soil has less humus and is less fertile. Gradually, the fertile land gets converted into deserts. It is called desertification. Desertification. So, desertification is one of the major result of deforestation. So, when the physical properties of soil gets affected by plantation and vegetation, the trees prevent the soil erosion, and fewer the trees, more and more soil erosion takes place. Removal of top layer of the soil exposes the lower hard and rocky layers, and this soil has less humus and is less fertile. Gradually, the fertile land gets converted into deserts. So, this process is called desertification. Next point, deforestation also leads to increase in the water holding capacity of the soil. So, if less plants are there, then water holding capacity of the soil also decreases. The movement of water from the soil surface into the ground also reduces. So, there are floods. The other properties of the soil like nutrient content, texture, etc. also change because of deforestation. So, the texture and properties and the nutrient content of the soil also decreases, and the water holding capacity of the soil also decreases due to deforestation. Now, next point is conservation of forest and wildlife. How can we conserve the forest and wildlife? That students Bujo and Paheli, they had asked their sir, Professor Ahmad, about the forest and wildlife. How can they save them? Now, how to save this wildlife and forest life? So, biosphere is that part of the earth in which living organism exists or which support life. Biological diversity or biodiversity refers to the variety of organisms existing on the earth, their interrelationships and their relationship with the environment. So, while biosphere is one of the main part of conserving the wildlife and the forest. So, biosphere is that part of the earth in which living organism exists or which supports life. Biological diversity or biodiversity refers to the variety of organisms existing on the earth, their interrelationships and their relationship with the environment. You had already studied in previous chapters about the natural resources. Natural resources are of two types. You had already studied. And there is also one group is there, that is animals and plants, including in that group. Other one is non-living types, soil, air, sunlight, minerals, all these things. And living factors includes plants and animals. Now, how can we protect these plants and animals? That we will freedom. To protect our flora and fauna. What is flora? What is fauna? Flora stands for plants and fauna stands for animals. To protect our flora and fauna and their habitats, protected areas called sanctuaries, national parks, and biosphere reserves have been earmarked. Plantation, cultivation, grazing, felling trees, hunting, and poaching are prohibited in these particular areas. So, to protect flora and fauna and their habitat, protected areas called sanctuaries, national parks, and biosphere reserves have been constructed. In these areas, plantation, cultivation, grazing, felling trees, hunting, and poaching are prohibited. First one, sanctuary. What is sanctuary? Areas where animals are protected from any disturbance to them and their habitat. These are done by the government. So the government lays down rules, methods, and policies to protect and conserve these sanctuaries or biospheres, etc. Wildlife sanctuaries, national parks, biosphere reserves, etc. are protected areas for conservation of plants and animals present in that area. Now, you can see a biosphere reserve. In your textbook, one picture is given, that is Panchmahi Biosphere Reserve. Look at here, Panchmahi Biosphere Reserve. There consists of Panchmahi Sanctuary, then you can see Satpura National Park, then Bori Sanctuary, etc. So, a biosphere consists of national parks are there, wildlife sanctuaries are there, all these together consist of biosphere reserve. So, what is biosphere reserve? You can see now. Children, along with the Professor Ahmed and Mahadev ji, enter the biosphere reserve area. So they visited one biosphere reserve area to study more about this conservation. And Mahadev ji explained that biosphere reserves are the areas meant for conservation of biodiversity. As you are aware, the biodiversity is the variety of plants, animals, and microorganisms generally found in an area. The biosphere reserves help to maintain the biodiversity and culture of that area. A biosphere reserve may also contain other protected areas in it. The Panchmahi Biosphere Reserve consists of one national park named Satpura and two wildlife sanctuaries named Bori and Panchmahi. That is given in this picture. So, Biosphere Reserve is a huge area, vast area preserved by the government. It consists of wildlife sanctuaries and national parks where all the flora and fauna is conserved and protected. entering and disturbing these areas is prohibited by the rules and regulations. There the animals can freely move from microorganism to very huge animals. They can live freely. They can multiply their numbers. They can feed their food. Everything they can do in this particular area. So biosphere reserve are the areas meant for conservation of biodiversity. Biodiversity is the variety of plants, animals and microorganisms generally found in an area. Biosphere reserves helps to maintain the biodiversity and culture of that area. A biosphere reserve may also contain other protected areas in it. So one example, Panchmarhi Biosphere Reserve consists of one national park named Satpura and two wildlife sanctuaries named Bori and Panchmarhi. So this is about the biosphere reserve. So students, I had explained main points of this part. We will continue the chapter in the next day. So today what I had explained, go through that. We will continue next video. Till then, goodbye.